Morning everybody. Today I am discussing about the antibiotic chloramphenicol. So this chloramphenicol is a broad spectrum antibiotic. Mainly it is obtained from the Streptomyces venezuelae in the year 1947. So this chloramphenicol is the drug which is obtained from the Streptomyces species, that is the bacteria. It is a gram positive bacteria, mainly used to treat the several diseases. So mainly this chloramphenicol is used to treat the gram positive bacteria as well as the gram negative bacteria. So it is called as a broad spectrum antibiotic drug. Next, coming to this properties of the chloramphenicol, it is yellowish in color. Mainly it is obtained by the process of fermentation. Next, the nitrobenzene ring. The nitrobenzene ring or the nitrobenzene moiety of the chloramphenicol acts as a antibacterial activity. It consists of the antibacterial activity. So chloramphenicol, it is obtained from the species, that is the Streptomyces venezuelae. It is obtained in the year 1947 by the fermentation process. So it has both a gram positive as well as the gram negative. It is a gram positive as well as a gram negative bactericidal and bacteriostatic activities. And the properties of the chloramphenicol is yellowish in color, and the nitrobenzene moiety of the chloramphenicol acts as an antibactericidal or the bacteriostatic drug. Next, coming to the the mechanism of action of the chloramphenicol is mainly it inhibits the protein synthesis, that is nothing but it inhibits the bacterial cell wall synthesis. So here in these conditions, amino acyl tRNA. So amino acyl tRNA binds to the ribosomes. So it is an amino acid, binds to the ribosomes. So in particular 50S ribosomes. In particular, it binds to the 50S ribosomes. General mechanism of action of the cell wall or the bacterial cell wall or either the fungal or viral cell wall is the peptide chain formation. So that peptide chain formation is due to the binding of the amino acyl tRNA to the ribosomes. So in the ribosomes, 50S ribosomes are involved in the binding of this particular enzyme. Here there is, whenever we are treating the drug, that is the chloramphenicol, the drug binds to the amino acyl tRNAs and it inhibits the peptide chain formation. So these peptide chains are involved in the synthesis of proteins, mainly in the ribosomes. So in these conditions, drug, it inhibits the peptide chain formation at the AATRNAs. The mechanism of action of the chloramphenicol is the drug, it binds to the peptide chains and it inhibits the formation of the peptide chain mainly at the amino acyl transferases, amino acyl transRNAs. Here it prevents the binding of this amino acyl transRNAs to the ribosomes. Next, coming to the antimicrobial spectrum. So already we know about that the chloramphenicol is a broad spectrum antibiotic. So it is involved in the inhibition of the either the gram positive or the gram negative bacteria. So mainly in the some of the diseases or the infectious diseases caused by the influenzas and Neisseria, meningitis, Salmonella, typhi and entamoeba are inhibited by or prevented by the drug chloramphenicol. Next, coming to this resistance to chloramphenicol. This resistance of chloramphenicol, it depends upon the following factors, or if the resistance may develop due to the following reasons. In that particular reasons, so first reason is the decreases in the cell permeability. So the resistance, mainly this chloramphenicol resistance by the body is due to the different mechanisms. In particular, the first one is the decreases in the cell permeability. So whenever there is a decrease in the permeability of the cell, there is no penetration of the drug into the cell wall, and it leads to resistance. Here in these cases, more amounts of chloramphenicol are deposited at the outer surfaces of the cell membrane. Next condition is the mutations. Next factor or the next mechanism is mutations. Here there is a decrease in the mutations of the A2451 residues. Okay, so first resistance is developed due to the decreases in the cell permeability, and second condition is the mutations, decrease in the activity of the mutations, or there is no formation of the mutations from this particular residues, that is A2451 residue. So this A2451 residue is present in the cell wall of the bacterial cell. Okay, so it mainly present in the bacterial cell wall, and these residues are involved in the formation of the proteins from the ribosomes. So this A2451 are the residues. So these residues are present in the ribosomes, some of the ribosomes in any of the bacteria. So these ribosomes in this condition decrease in the protein synthesis. So there is no formation of proteins from the particular residues which are present in the ribosomes. Next condition is the activation of CAT, activation of CAT. So in this condition, CAT is the chloramphenicol acetyl transferases, or chloramphenicol acyl transferases. Okay, so these chloramphenicol acyl transferases are the enzymes which are present in the cells, either the bacterial or the viral or the fungi cells. So the action of the CATs, that is nothing but the chloramphenicol acyl transferases, are the enzymes. It inhibits the actions of the chloramphenicol during this the development of resistance. Okay. Next, coming to the pharmacokinetics. The chloramphenicol is rapidly. So whenever we are taking the chloramphenicol, it is mainly enters into our gastrointestinal tract by the oral route or by during ingestion process. So whenever it enters into the GI tract, it may bounce to the plasma protein. Nearly 50 to 60% of the drug may bounce to the plasma proteins, and the volume of distribution of the chloramphenicol is 1 L per kg, 1 liter per kg, and it directly penetrates into the serous fluid and it crosses the blood-brain barrier. And the T-half of the chloramphenicol is 3 to 5 hours. Next, coming to the adverse effects of the chloramphenicol is mainly it disturbs or it damages the bone marrow. So continuous usage of the chloramphenicol, it may lead to toxic effects, and the toxic effects are the bone marrow depression or bone marrow suppression. So during this bone marrow suppression, so what happens means during this bone marrow suppression, there is no formation of RBC and WBC from the bone marrow. So during in these conditions, agranulocytopenia the adverse effects which is caused due to the bone marrow depression is the agranulocytopenia, thrombocytopenia, next aplastic anemia, and pancytopenia. So either the agranulocytopenia or thrombocytopenia or the aplastic anemia or pancytopenia is due to the depression of the bone marrow. So in these conditions, there is no formation of new, there is no newly formed blood vessels, blood cells, that is nothing but RBC, either the WBC or the thrombocytes. Next, drug interactions of the chloramphenicol. So this chloramphenicol is mainly interacted with the drugs, that is with the morphine and warfarins. It interacts with the morphine as well as warfarin, chlorpromide and phenytoin. So it mainly increases the toxicity of the phenytoin. Next, another adverse effects or the contraindication of adverse effects of this chloramphenicol is the Gray baby syndrome. Gray baby syndrome. Gray baby syndrome. This is also the another adverse effect of the chloramphenicol. One adverse effect is the depression of the bone marrow. Another adverse effect is the gray baby syndrome. So all of you know about this gray baby syndrome. Means what are the signs and symptoms of the gray baby syndrome? Is the fever, skin rashes, and also there is a discoloration of the skin and it may turns into the blue color. So this gray baby syndrome is mainly caused by the usage of the chloramphenicol drug. So mainly it can be seen in the infants as well as in the children. Mostly infants are affected to the chloramphenicol drug. Next, coming to the drug interactions, already I said that it can be interacted with the chlorpropamide, warfarin, and it may leads to phenytoin toxicities, and also it acts against the beta lactam antibiotics. Next, contraindications of the chloramphenicol. So generally all the drugs may be contraindicated in the pregnancy as well as in lactation conditions, and also in infants and in, you know, geriatric patients. So moreover, and it can be contraindicated in GPCD disorder patients. That is nothing but glucose J6PD, glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenases. So even when a person may have a G6PD deficiency, so that G6PD deficiency patients also may contraindicated with the chloramphenicol drug. Next, coming to this therapeutic uses. So mainly this chloramphenicol or any of the antibiotics are mostly used in the bacterial as well as fungal viral infectious disease. So this chloramphenicol is mainly used in the treatment of the Salmonella typhi, or in mainly in the typhoid fever. So in 1980s, so this is the first drug which can be used to treat the typhoid fever in 1980s, and it also used to treat the bacterial infection, that is rickettsia and also chlamydia. So rickettsia, the symptoms are associated during the rickettsial disease is the skin rashes as well as fever, nausea, vomiting. So all of the side effects are common, and chlamydia is a STD diseases, and also used to treat the intraocular infections and anaerobic infections, and mainly used in the conjunctivitis and external ear infections. Okay, so this is about the chloramphenicol drug. So if you have any doubts, please ask me. Okay, thank you.